Hey guys, in this tutorial video, I'm going to show you how you can install aimtell's web push notifications manually. For those that are also interested, we do have various plugins, such as WordPress plugins, which is going to take care of everything I'm about to do automatically. This is more the step-by-step if you want to do it yourself. Okay, so I have an example website here, which we're going to try to get push notifications set up on. It's just a basic Bootstrap theme. It's just a template that I just downloaded. Okay, so the first step is we're going to go ahead and log in. Go to dashboard.aimtell.com/login. And log into your account. Once you're in, go to Websites, Add Website. Here you're going to notice three fields, the push icon, the name, and the URL. These are important to note because the push name and icon will show when a user visits your website and looks to subscribe. For instance, here's an example on our website. You'll see the website aimtell would like to send you push notifications in the notification center. This is the name you provided, and this is the icon. So we're going to go ahead and just make a name here. We're going to say great website and enter our URL and upload an icon. It's recommended this icon is 250 pixels by 250. Mainly just get the ratio to be a nice square. You can upload up to 1 megabyte in size. I'm going to go ahead and create the website. Once it's done, we just need to follow these two small steps. The first is to upload the required files to the root directory, and the second is to add the JavaScript snippet. So we're going to download these files, go ahead and open it up, and we have that just right here. And then we're going to go ahead and grab our site directory too. So all you need to do is just copy these two files to your website, the root directory there. It's usually the one that has the index.html. So that's the first part, and the second part, grab the tracking code, copy, then just open your website up in your favorite editor. In this case, I'm using Sublime, and then find the closing body tag and paste this code. This is an example for a site that only has one page. If you have multiple pages, you should put this at the footer of every single page, which is usually done with a footer.php or template file. Go ahead and click save. Then we're just gonna open up our favorite FTP editor to update our website. There's various tutorials on the web on how to do this. And then we're going to just go ahead and upload these files to update our website. Going to overwrite. And we're done. Now if you go back to your website, and if you check it out, I'll load this again. You'll see that we get the prompt for notifications. I'm going to go ahead and click allow. Also, you can see the same if you go back to your Safari browser, reload the website. You'll notice that we get the prompt with the logo and the name. Okay, one final note, we're not going to cover that in depth in this tutorial video, but if you'd like to manage which pages that prompt shows on, that can be handled under the prompt management. You can check out our other tutorials to find more information on that. Thanks, guys.